Myself Prashant, lecturer in physics. Now, today I am going to continue with the chapter nuclei of PU2. So, in the previous class, we have discussed about the points: what is mass defect, what is binding energy, and also we have discussed about the specific binding energy, that is binding energy for nucleon. Right, the mass defect is what? The mass defect is the sum of the masses of the nucleons forming the nucleus, forming the stable nucleus, and the rest mass of the nucleus is called as the mass defect. Right, the mass defect, how you represented, delta m is equal to z into mp plus A minus Z into Mn minus M. So this is the mass of the stable nucleus, and this is the mass of the nucleons forming a stable nucleus. So there is some mass is missed. That mass is converted into energy. That energy is required to bind the nucleons to form a stable nucleus. So according to Einstein mass energy relation, this missed mass or lost in mass is converted into energy. That energy is required to bind the nucleons to form a stable nucleus. So this is about the mass defect we have discussed in the previous class, and the binding energy, right? Binding energy, the amount of energy required to hold the nucleons or to bind the nucleons to form a stable nucleus, or the amount of energy required to break the nucleus to form the constituent nucleons. And what is specific binding energy? What is a specific binding energy, or the binding energy per nucleon, right? The binding energy per nucleon is called as the specific binding energy. So how you represent it, right? The specific binding energy is equal to specific binding energy can be represented here, right? Delta M, that is mass defect, into 931 mega electron volt. You know that 1 AMU is equal to 931 mega electron volt, right? This is divided by the atomic mass number, that is A, this total number of neutrons. So this gives the specific binding energy in terms of mega electron volt. So in this way, we can represent the specific binding energy or binding energy per nucleon, right? That is delta M into 931 divided by A, that is total number of nucleons. This A is what? Total number of nucleons or mass number. This is total number of nucleons or mass number, specific binding energy, right? This is binding energy per nucleon. The binding energy per nucleon. So in this way, we are representing the specific binding energy or the binding energy per nucleon, right? And what is the significance of the binding energy or specific binding energy? The significance of the specific binding energy, which tells us about the stability of the nucleus. It tells us about what? The stability of the nucleus, right? The stability of the nucleus is directly proportional to the specific binding energy. Stability of the nucleus is directly proportional to the specific binding energy or binding energy per nucleon, right? If binding energy per nucleon is less, then the nucleus is less stable, whereas the nucleus is more stable if the binding energy per nucleon is higher. Higher the specific higher the specific binding energy per nucleon, more stable is the nucleus. Lower or lesser the value of specific binding energy per nucleon, the nucleus is less stable. The stability is directly proportional to the binding, specific binding energy or binding energy per nucleon. Right. Now, with this, now let us draw a binding energy curve. Right. Binding energy curve, and we'll discuss the important silent features of binding energy curve. Right. What is binding energy curve? So now we have got the points about binding energy and binding energy per nucleon. So here I am going to represent about what? The binding energy curve. So what is the binding energy curve here? The binding energy curve, it is the representation of variation of binding energy per nucleon, the variation of binding energy per nucleon with the mass number of different nuclei is called as the binding energy curve. So it is what? The graph between the specific binding energy and the mass number A of various nuclei is called as binding energy curve. So this graph represents what here? The variation of the binding energy per nucleon versus the mass number of different nuclei. This graph is called as the binding energy curve. Right. Now, the study of the binding energy curve reveals some important information about the nuclei. Right. About the nuclei. What are these important points? Those are revealed from the binding energy curve. Those are also called as the silent features of the binding energy curve. What are the silent features of the binding energy curve here? The first one, the silent features of the binding energy curve, the first one is the binding energy per nucleon or specific binding energy is less for lighter nuclei. It is what? Less for lighter nuclei. So that means what? The binding energy is less means the nucleus is less stable. For an atomic mass number less than 3, the binding energy per nucleon is very, very small. Then these nuclei are less stable, right? This is the first point we are getting from the binding energy curve. Now, the next point is what? In the lighter nuclei region, the binding energy per nucleon increases sharply. As you observe the graph, there is an increase in the graph sharply from the lighter nuclei region, right? And the graph reaches to a maximum value of 8.7 mega electron volt for an atomic mass number A is equal to 56. It is the atomic mass number and the atomic mass number of iron, it is A is equal to 56, it is iron. So, from the lighter nuclei region to the graph sharply increases and the binding energy per nucleon reaches to a maximum value of 8.7 mega electron volt, that is for iron, A is equal to 56. Now, the next point, what happens for an atomic mass number greater than 30 and less than 170? For a nuclei with mass number between 30 and 170, the binding energy per nucleon is almost close to the maximum value and it is constant, right? So then what happens to the nuclei stability for this, right? So binding energy per nucleon is constant in this region, that is atomic mass number between 30 to 170, the binding energy per nucleon is close to the maximum value and it is constant about 8 mega electron volt, and hence these nuclei are
more stable, that is not nuclei are constant, that is these nuclei are more stable, right. So, the nuclei comes under the reason between the atomic mass number 30 and 170 are more stable. So, this is what the next point we are getting from the binding energy curve here, right. Now, the next point is what happens to the nuclei of the atomic mass number greater than 170, right. For a nuclei of atomic mass number greater than 170, the binding energy per nucleon is decreases. The binding energy per nucleon goes on decreases and reaches to a value of 7.6 mega electron volt. For an atomic mass number greater than 170, the binding energy per nucleon reaches to a value of 7.6 mega electron volt. At an atomic mass number of 238 for an uranium, then what happens to this stability, right? When it reaches to a value of 7.6 mega electron volt for A is equal to 238, then what happens to the stability of the nucleus after an atomic mass number greater than 238, right? So, for an heavy nucleus, an atomic mass number A is greater than 240, whose binding energy per nucleon is less, right? Hence, what happens? If the binding energy per nucleon is less, then that nucleus is less stable. So, then what happens here? What is the nuclear fission? The breaking of heavy nucleus, the heavy nucleus splits into lighter nuclei. Hence, what happens? For an atomic mass number A is greater than 240, what happens here? Those nuclei try to undergo fission and try to attain the stability, and they becomes lighter nuclei. What happens to uranium nucleus? So, it splits into barium and krypton, right. Then it try to attain the stability, right. So, the heavy nucleus whose binding energy per nucleon is less, and they try to undergo what? The fission to attain the stability. Hence, during the process, the energy is also released there. Right. Again, for lighter nuclei, what happens? For an lighter nuclei of atomic mass number less than 10, right. For a lighter nuclei of atomic mass number less than 10, whose binding energy per nucleon is less, and they try to undergo the stability by the process of fusion, right. So, what is the conclusion we can give from the study of the binding energy curve here? Right. So, we have discussed the important silent features of the binding energy curve here. We have discussed the important silent features of the binding energy curve. One thing we are getting here, what? In the reason, atomic mass number between A is equal to 30 to 170, these nucleus are stable because their binding energy per nucleon is maximum and it is constant. For in the lighter nuclear region and heavier nuclear region, what happens? Their binding energy per nucleon is less, and they try to attain the stability by the process of fission and by the process of fusion. The nuclei of heavy nucleus, they undergo fission process, and the lighter nuclei, they undergo fusion process, and they try to attain the stability by these two processes. Now, these are the important features of what? The binding energy curve. So, the binding energy curve tells us about the stability of the nuclei, which gives about what? Which gives the information about the stability of the nuclei, which nuclei is more stable, which nuclei is less stable, and it also gives an information about why the nuclear fission and nuclear fusion processes occurs. So, this is what about the binding energy curve information we are getting, right. The next,
mass defect and specific binding energy of nitrogen 714. We have to calculate what here? The mass defect and the specific binding energy. What are the given points here? The rest mass of the nucleus is given, that The rest mass of the nucleus is 14.00307 amu. Mass of the proton is given 1.00783 amu. Mass of the neutron is given 1.00867 amu. Right. Now the solution. So from this N714, right, given, we can write here the A is equal to 14 and Z is equal to 7. Atomic number is 7, atomic mass number is 14. So the mass defect, you can write delta M is equal to Z into MP plus A minus Z into MN minus M. This is the rest mass of the nucleus. This is the mass sum of the masses of the nucleons in the free state. Now delta M is equal to, so A minus Z number of neutrons is, A minus Z is equal to 7. Z is 7. So 7 into mass of proton is 1.00783 plus A minus Z is 7. Again, so 7 into mass of neutron is 1.00867. Next, minus mass of the rest mass of the nucleus, that is minus, you can write here minus 14.00307. Now multiply these two, 7 into this bracket plus 7 into this bracket minus 14.00307. So you will get 7.05. 7 into 1.00783. So after the multiplication, what you will get here? 7.05481 plus 7 into this bracket is 7.06069. Next, minus 14.00307. So add and subtract this, what you will get? The mass defect delta M is equal to, so 14 point, so adding these two, what you will get? 14.1155 minus 14.00307. Therefore, the mass defect delta M is equal to 0. What you will get here? 11240 AMU. This is the mass defect in terms of what? AMU. What we have done the calculation, right? Delta M in terms of AMU, right? Now, the first point. Calculate the mass defect we have got. The value of mass defect is 0.11243 AMU. Now, the next point what we have to calculate here, specific binding energy. Before that, what we want here, please note down all these points, right? So now what we want here, specific binding energy. Before that, we have to find what is binding energy. Binding energy what? Binding energy is equal to mass defect into, we know that the relation 1 AMU is equal to 931 mega electron. If 1 AMU amount of mass is adjusted, that is converted into energy as 931 mega electron volt. So that the amount of mass defect is here 0.11243, so we can multiply it 931 mega electron volt, so you will get the binding energy. Therefore, binding energy is equal to, binding energy is equal to delta M into 931 this is 0.11243 into 930. So after the multiplication, you will get 104.7285. So mega electron. So this is what the binding energy. So this is what the binding energy.
Now specific binding energy is binding energy.
Specific binding energy is equal to what now? Specific binding energy or binding energy per nucleon. Specific binding energy is equal to binding energy divided by A. Binding energy is 104.7285 divided by A is atomic mass number is 14, right? Therefore, you will get what? 7 point after dividing, you will get 7.48 mega electron. So this is what? The specific binding energy. This is the binding energy. So this is the mass defect. So in this way, you have to calculate the problems and the numericals based on the concept mass defect and a binding energy and specific binding energy. Please follow this. Next, solve the next problem.